Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here. Approximately 12:45 in Honolulu, 6:45 in New York. It is Tuesday, April the 13th, 2021, and this is the daily report for gold and silver. The CPI numbers came out for March. They came in hotter than expected. We saw that move gold and silver very, very nicely to the upside, about a $15 gain in gold, about a 50-cent gain in silver. Also, cryptocurrency Bitcoin broke through $63,000, and I highly recommend that you look at the Bitcoin section of the gold forecast today. That being said, we will talk about our current trade in gold futures and Forex along with the EFTs, and that show will begin now. Nice gains in gold and silver today. We are looking at the activity as it opens in Australia. Trading in New York resulted in gold closing at 1746.20. It is currently at 1746.80 and had an advance of approximately $14 in trading in New York. This first chart that we're looking at is a daily candlestick chart of June gold. We can see that it is clearly broken above the 21-day exponential moving average that is drawn in cyan right here and closed well above that. However, the 50-day moving average, which you can see has been moving lower, is definitely still a resistance area, with the first level of any kind of real resistance coming in at the 78% retracement level of 1762.10. If you recall, this is a different data set that we have been using to create this, because rather than going back to the lows of March, on this data set, as you can see, we're really focusing in on a triple bottom per se, but definitely we had this activity in May and June of last year where this particular price point around 1780 was definitely an area of support. And then this double bottom beginning of March and then again at the beginning of April. So the fact of the matter is we have seen a fairly decent move off of these lows. We have touched near the highs that came in last week and now are once again challenging these particular areas that are now what I am looking at as interim or short-term resistance in the market. An effective close above 1762 would be extremely bullish. It does match up also with this low that came in back in December. This chart that we are looking at is also a daily chart, but it is in Hankinashi or Japanese average format. Of course, the key difference between those two types of charts, Japanese candlesticks and the Hankinashi, is that the open on a Hankinashi is fixed upon the midpoint of the prior candle. So whereas we saw these go red for 2 days, we're now back in green. Although it's not a large candle, it does signify that we are back in a bullish trend. But really, what we do want to see more than anything else on a technical basis is a close above the 50-day moving average, because that would certainly signal a return to a fully short-term bullish demeanor. Maintain your current long position in gold and maintain your long position in GLD. And speaking about GLD, we'll go ahead and pull up a chart. And we can see that GLD gained $1.15 per share and is currently fixed at 163.43 per share. That's a net gain of about 0.75%. Silver, basis the most active May contract, closed out at $25.40. That was a net gain of 2.16%, with the May contract gaining about 54 cents. You can see that it is currently actively trading in Australia at 25.43, so up about 3 cents from New York trading. Lastly, the dollar index did close lower today, losing 31 points and is currently fixed at 91.83. Very strong move today in silver, gaining about 50 cents in trading today. It also closed above the 21-day moving average. But as you can see, when we look at the 50-day moving average, it is quite a distance away from current pricing. And that's effectively what I would like to see. Also, that aligns up with the 50% retracement that comes in at 2614. So we had our first sign, a solid sign, in that silver closed above the 21-day moving average. We'll get extremely bullish on this market after we see a break above, say, 2615. Lastly, I do want to take a quick look at SLV. That gained approximately 2%, 47 cents per share, and is currently tracking at $23.51 per share. Traders, maintain your current long positions in both Forex, futures, silver, and gold, as well as ETFs, SLV, and GLD. This has been Gary Wagner, wishing you, as always, good trading. We will talk to you tomorrow for the next daily update and review. Bye-bye.